Level A. Okay. Go.
Well, hello everyone and welcome back to my channel where we are looking on using the M-Pesa Daraja API using Django and React Native to make real-world mobile applications both for Android and iOS. In the previous video, we looked at how we could save our Lipa na M-Pesa transaction to our database. And in this video, we are going to look at how we can save our C2B transactions to our database. In one of our initial videos, we looked at the differences between C2B and Lipa na M-Pesa. And so far, we've only been focusing on Lipa na M-Pesa. So remember, we said that for C2B, you pay for M-Pesa from your SIM or your mobile phone SIM, and the request goes straight to the Daraja API where they process your request and immediately give you an asynchronous acknowledgement telling you whether it's a success or not. Then it begins the process of an asynchronous response cycle where it first sends you some data to your validation URL where you are supposed now to accept or reject the transaction that a customer is trying to send to you using their SIM card. You send that information to Safaricom telling them, hey, I'm either accepting or rejecting this transaction. And in case you decide to accept the transaction, meaning it's a response of code of zero, then Daraja is going to send you the final data to your confirmation URL. Again, remember we say one of the main differences between Lipa na M-Pesa and C2B is that for C2B we must have a validation URL and a confirmation URL. So these are the various response types where this part is synchronous and the rest is purely asynchronous, apart from where you are responding, which in this case is going to be a synchronous response. Okay, so similarly, last time, instead of one URL, we are going to have two URLs. We are also going to have two views because each URL is going to have its own view. And the first view we are going to have is the validation API view where Safaricom is going to send you information and you're supposed to process that. And we're also going to have a C2B confirmation API view. This is the last step where now you are going to save the transaction after you've accepted or rejected it. And similarly as last time, it's going to be the same structure. We are going to have a validation API view. So this is where you are going to receive the initial data. So if you print request.data, similarly like what we did in the previous video, you are going to receive similar data like what is here below. And then you can use this data to do some validation. So for example, assume you have a shop, or let me just use another example. Assume like you are a landlord and you want people to pay their rent. So you can either decide that I will only be accepting the full amount. So you are going to have a pay bill number, and this bill reference number is the account number. So each tenant will have their own account number, and you can decide if somebody sends you money which is not equivalent to the rent that you owe them, you are going to automatically reject the transaction. So what you can do here with some validation is that you can come and extract this amount and check against your backend whether this person has sent you the amount that you wanted. If not, then you can decide to reject the transaction. Another way that you can use this validation, for example, is that because you are going to have one pay bill and numerous account numbers, so let's say each tenant has their own account number, if by chance somebody goes and sends you money to your correct pay bill but the account number they've put is wrong, you can counter check that with your backend and reject the transaction and, you know, send them a message saying that account number does not exist in our pay bill. Again, here it's endless possibilities of what you can do with validation. Again, that shifts from client to client, and in the future videos when we actually be doing an actual project, we are going to do some validation. So then you're supposed to return a response, and this response, if you return a response with a result code of zero, then you are telling Safaricom like, hey, I accept this. If you return with a result code of like 1, you are saying you've rejected the transaction, and we are going to see that in the code. So if you accept the transaction, then this you send back to Safaricom, then Safaricom will send now final data to your confirmation API view. Again, we do a def create. We can print request.data to see the similar data that we get. And then after that, we are going to do some extracting this data and now saving it to our database. Cool. Now, after that, we are going to work backwards and create our models from the data that we've extracted, similar as to what we did with Lipa and M-Pesa. We are going to save that into the database. Without further ado, I'm going to jump straight to the code. And in this example, I'm going to go really quickly because we've already covered this in the previous video. So going back to our code, I'm going to come here to M-Pesa and I'm going to open up our views. And this is what we did last time, where we had a Lipa na Mpesa callback URL. And in this case, we want to create now for C2B validation API view. So I'm just going to copy everything that we did to there. And I'm going to minimize this like so. And I'm going to paste this because it's quite similar. And I'm going to delete everything here all the way up to, so that we just remain with a print request.data. And a response, and I'm going to call this C2B. Call this C2B validation API view. We see a query set. We need a model which we don't have, so I'm going to open our models, and I'm going to create a new model. I'm going to call it class C2B payments, which is models.model. Okay, and I'm going similarly as last time, say pass, because we do not know the fields that Safaricom is going to send. I mean, I already know, but for this, we are going just to do like last time, and we say we don't know because we've not received any. And I'm going to copy this in view. So instead of that, I'm going to import that, and I make sure I've also imported it here. That's correct. Going to delete that. We need a serializer class, so I need to come here and create a new serializer. So I'm going to copy this and I'm going to paste here, and I'm going to call this C2B payment serializer. Again, the model is going to be this C2B payments. That's what we've called it here. So I'm going to come here and say C2B payments. So that's okay. And remember, because we do not know the fields or the data that is going to send, we are just going to say fields is equals to either an empty array or just ID, because we know at least each transaction is going to have a unique primary key. So then I'm going to import this serializer in our views. So I'm going to come here and import that C2B payment serializer. And exchange that for that. So I'm going to say this is request.data in validation. So that we know, because we are dealing with two URLs. And I'm going to similarly copy this and use that for the confirmation API. So I'm going to call this C2B. I'm going to come here and change this to be confirmation and response. I'm going to say result description here. I'm going to return a result description of 0. Okay, so remember, there's one important thing we've said. So for validation API view, it's important to note that if you do not have a def create method, Safaricom is going to automatically assume that you've accepted everything and is going to skip the validation. So for example, if I were to, hide that out in the code, Safaricom is going to come to our validation API view, but then it's going to check our code and see we've not done any validation. So it's going to assume automatically that we've accepted. Actually, initially, let's go with that and assume that we've not done any validation, and you'll see what I'm talking about. So I'm going to do that. The only thing that is remaining is what? Let's see, C2B payment serializer. The serializer is there. We've done the model. And we've also, done the permissions. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to push this to Heroku. But before I do that, I'm going to come to our samples folder and to C2B, because this is the code that we'll be using. And remember, in C2B, before we do a transaction, we must check one thing. We must do our register URL, which we said we only do once when you go to production. And here we are using the wrong URL. So I'm going to change this to the correct URL, then register that URL so that whenever we come and do the simulate C2B, because here you see we are not writing the confirmation validation URL, Safaricom will know where to send. So I'm going to come to my browser and copy my address, and I'm going to exchange these two with that. Oops, I've forgotten one thing. So after doing the views, we need to do the URLs. So I'm going to come here to the URLs. I'm going to copy this. We need to know which, and I'm going to paste twice. So the first URL that we need to create is C2B. Validation, and with this one, of course, I've already imported the C2B validation and C2B confirmation. So this is going to be, make sure this is imported, and I'm going also to copy that one. So validation, and I'm going to call this C2B. Validation. And I'm going to call this C2B confirmation. So now, because we've already done these two URLs, we come to now to the samples folder to C2B. And now this will be mysterious oasis 1355 or whatever your app is. Again, we are going to change this in the course of time. And it's forward slash. So remember, we say that after doing forward slash, it's going to come to the main URLs, which is inside the Daraja URLs. And our URLs are now in M-Pesa API URL. So it's going to be forward slash API, forward slash payment. So I'm going to copy this. Come here to URLs, no C2B. So both of them are going to be forward slash API, forward slash payments, and we've called this C2B confirmation, and we've called this C2B validation. Again, remember to always add a trailing edge to our transaction. So, okay. So now that we have this, now let's go ahead and register this. So I'm going to run this function, but I'm not going to do the simulation first, like that. Okay, and I'm going to register these two URLs, which is our, now it's production URL, because we have now a working URL, and I'm going to run this. So Control Shift P, run Python file in terminal. And we get an error here saying HTTPS connection failed, maximum retries done. Okay, let me see what might be the problem. Okay, let's see what, everything is okay, HTTPS is okay. I'm going to retry this and run this Python file in terminal. Okay, so here the problem is saying is that an SSL error, but this error is not coming from our side, it's coming from the Safaricom side. So the way we'll go about solving this, again, whenever you get this error, sometimes the Safaricom server does not configure its SSL certificates well enough, so you will need to do it on our side. So I'm going to close this, and the way we do it is Yeah, when you're making the response, I can come here and say verify is equals to true. No, is equals to false. So I'm asking my site not to verify the SSL certificates from Safaricom, because sometimes the certificates are usually configured wrongly. So sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. So Control Shift P again. And I'm going to run this file again. Okay, so I get the same error. But here it's because here it's saying the error is in generating the client credentials, which is not this. Remember here we are importing the access token from generate access token. So I'm going to come back to this file access token. And because inside the same file there's also the request, I'm going to say here comma verify is equals to false. So we'll have to pretty much do this to every request we are making, even B2B, B2C, and everything else that we'll be doing. So Control Shift P, run. No, we don't need to run this file. We need to run the C2B, but it's okay. At least this one now works. I need to run this again, and now we should receive a success message. So we receive a success message. We've generated the access token. And also here, because it's coming from this function of generate access token, and also here the response of register URL, it's saying it's a success. But also notice here we are getting a warning. It's saying insecure warning, unverified HTTPS request is being made. And the reason is unverified. We've said we don't verify the SSL certificates on the Safaricom side. And they're telling us to add a certificate verification. Okay, so because this works sometimes and sometimes it doesn't, so what I'll do is that I'm going to use a try except statement. I'm going to say always try. I'm going to cut this. So in our function, I'm going to say whenever we run this function of register URL, first of all, try. To do this without the verify, so that is always secure. But in case there's an error and Safaricom SSL certificates are not working, then run that. So the default will be this, and if there's an error, it's going to revert back to this. I'm going to do the same method with the access token generation as well. This will be try. I'm going to put that there. Accept. I'm going to copy this, paste it here, and of course the first one is where verification is there by default, and the second one it falls back to that one, so that if Safaricom server is working correctly, it runs this. If it's not, then it falls back to that one. Awesome. Now just to run this again, C2B, going to close all this, Control Shift P, run Python file in terminal, and we get an access token, and we also get a success. Where is it? And we also get a success. So we successfully registered our URL. So I don't need to run this again. Awesome. Now what we need to do is simulate a C2B transaction. Remember we said we've set up these two URLs, but for the first URL, which is in C2B validation, we've not done any create or any custom method, so Safaricom will automatically assume we've accepted. So we should go straight to the confirmation API view. Before I do that, we need to upload everything to Heroku, so I'm going to add everything. I'm going to put a message of saying validation and confirmation URLs. And I'm going to push this to Heroku. Uh, and that has been uploaded. So I'm going to come back to the Chrome and check my logs. So that is done. I'm going to refresh the admin. Come back here. Everything works. So what now what should happen is that if I come to C2B and I run this simulate C2B transaction of 2 shillings to this number, let's see if we are going to get any data. Control Shift P. I'm going to run this Python file in terminal. I should receive a I'm receiving again an SSL certificate, so I need to do the same here to this response. So I'm going to say try accept. I'm going to cut this and paste it there, as well as paste it here. So I'll say no for the first one is okay. For the second one, I'm going to say verify is equals to false. Okay, Control Shift P, run this Python file in terminal until we see a success. Saying indent, okay, need to correctly do that and cancel out this pass. Control Shift P. Run this Python file in terminal again. Don't worry too much about all the formatting issues. So accept. So it has gone. So if I open up my logs, it's telling me that this URL is not found. API payments C2B confirmation. It's a 404 error. So let's go back to our main URL. So all URLs in API, M-Pesa API is API payments. Let's make sure that's the correct one. So it's API payments. Then when we come to these URLs, it's okay. So this validation is okay. So the confirmation one, what we are sending to here, we've called it C2B confirmation. So here is where the error is. This is supposed to be C2B confirmation, like so. Okay, and coming back to the logs, this is the URL it was saying it cannot find because we are not registered here correctly. So I'm going to add everything and I say correct confirmation URL. Going to say correct. I'm going to push this to Heroku. As it does that, let me come back to the log. Make sure that everything is okay. That was the only error. Okay. And now we wait for it to upload. So it has finished uploading. I'm going to confirm this on the logs. It has finished. I'm going to refresh the admin just to make sure everything is okay and the recording. It is. So I'm going to come back here again and run this C2B file. Control Shift P, run Python file in terminal. We should see a success. Success. And coming here, we should. And now we have received the confirmation data. So I'm going to copy this, and if we come back to our views, this is the data that we've gotten. So I'm going to three double quotes, like so. So this is the data that we've received. I'm going to maximize this. This is the information that we've received from Safaricom. So again, it's quite similar to what we had in the Lipa na M-Pesa online. The advantage with this is that it's pretty much well formatted. It's not like the other one, which we had dictionaries inside dictionaries. So this one is pretty straightforward, and we can even go ahead and save it just the way it is. So we've received a transaction time, which is pay bill, of course, because we are doing a pay bill, not a till number. And this can be seen in our C2B. I'm going to close majority of these files. We won't be using them again. For now, This is because here we've said it's customer pay bill online, so transaction time is pay bill. So if you have a pay bill number or a till number, you can use this to sort them out. We have a transaction ID. This is also the same ID that have been sent, your customer will receive through an SMS. This is a transaction time, again is a string formatted time. The amount is 2 shillings, what we've sent here. Let's see what else we've received. Business short code is our business short code. In this case, if you go live, it's going now to be a pay bill number, bill reference number. This was the account number, and this was what we sent, bill reference number, similar to that. Invoice number, right now blank. Organization account balance. It's only you who's going to receive this organizational account balance. Third party transaction ID is blank. Test phone number. This is the test phone number that we've used. In this case, because remember in C2B, we've used the keys.test msisdn. And if you come to keys, this is the number that we've used. We also get the first name, middle name, and the last name of the whoever sent you the money, and you can also use this to verify. So in this case, we've skipped the validation API view, and we've come straight to confirmation API view. So I'm going to work backwards and save this to the serializer. Again, this is because the data that we've received is pretty straightforward, unlike last time where we had dictionaries inside dictionary, so we can pretty much go ahead and save this. So I'm just going to go and copy this. Again, we'll come back to the validation API view later on, but now we'll just be saving everything. So I'm going to come now to our serializers, and we need to put everything here in the fields. So I'm just going to paste this one. So I need to copy everything. So copy that. This is a nice shortcut to use. I'm holding down the control button. Cut that. I can just delete everything. Then I'll come here and paste everything. Again, select all the words here. Put the comma and format this correctly so it looks nice and clean. Again, I'm going to copy in the views. I'm going to copy everything here again, and I'm going to come back to my models, and we need to fill in those values here. So I'm going to copy this. So I'm going to start with the transaction type. So I'll say transaction type is equals to models dot. We are going to select Chaffield max length. I'm going to put a 15. So then I'm going to take the trans ID, say trans ID, and this is still letters, so models dot Chaffield max length. I'm going to say it's usually around it's 10, so I'm just going to put 12 for the sake. Trans time in this case is a string. The other time it was a big integer field. So models dot char field. I'm going to put max length is equals to, this will always be constant, so I can just put 14 confidently. We're going to have a trans amount, which again, here Safaricom is sending this in terms of a string, which I really don't like, because ideally this should be a float number, but they've sent us a string. So for now, we are just going to do that. Models.charfield. But ideally, down the line, we can come and edit this and change this to be an integer. So I'm going to say models.char field. Max length is equals to, let me put 6, no, let me put 12. We need a business shortcode, so I'm going to copy that there. Again, we said this one, you can call it them anything you want. I just like keeping it the same with what Safaricom has sent. Again, this is I'm just going to go and copy this. And this is a fixed one, it's always 6, by the way. The short code length never changes. We have a we have a bill reference number, so I'm going to copy that. I'm going to copy this, and a bill reference number, I'm going to put 20 for this one. We have an invoice number which is blank, so I'm going to say is equals to similar to this, but this can always be blank or null. We have an organization account number. Again, let me just copy this many times. Seems everything here is a string. So we have the organizational account number, paste that, and account balance, I mean. Here I'm going just to put 12. We have third party trans ID. We have a phone number, and the length I'm assuming never changes is 12. So phone number, and this one I'm going to put is 12. We have a first name. I'm going to copy this and paste it twice. And we have a middle name. And lastly, a last name. Perfect. If you remember last time, one of the other things that we did is that we put everything as blank is equals to true, because we had already done the migrations. So I'm going to similarly do this again. Down the line, we are going to come back and change and remove some of this blank is equals to true, because the only thing that we need to put blank is equals to true, because we never receive the value, is the invoice number, and sometimes we also do not get the third party transaction ID. So I'm going to come here, I'm in models, selected that, select this, select that, select that. I'm going to say blank is equals to true, and also null is equals to true. I said here blank supposed to be equals. Perfect. I'm going to save this. Yeah, the max length of transaction type, then I'm going to put a 12. Everything is set. The only thing that we need to do is the admin. I'm going to come and just say, for now, I'm going to come and say admin.site.register. Actually, let me just copy everything here, and I'm going to, and this one will be C2B payments. I'm going to call this C2B payments admin. List display is supposed to be a list of some of the things here we are showcasing. I think in this case, in the previous case, we are doing phone number. So in this case, the phone number is called MSISDN. So I'm going to copy this. Amount is, here is being called a trans amount, so I'm going to copy this. The receipt number in this case is being called the trans ID. I'm going to put this, and transaction date is being called, let's see, trans time. So I'm going to put this, put it trans time. Of course, here, yeah, the difference is that this should copy. This needs to come here. And the here the model, we've called it C2B payments. So this needs to come here, and we need to import it up here as well. So since everything is set, what we need to do is, I'm going to save this. I need to come here to Daraja. I need to push this to Heroku, but before that we need to do migrations because we've changed. Because here, even anytime we change the model, we must do the migration. So I'm going to come to Daraja settings. In the init file, I'm going to make sure I'm in local. I'm going to close that one. And I'm going to come here and say Python manage.py, make migrations. Let's see, yeah. Can migrate. Okay, it has migrated. Then I'm going to return the way it was. Now we push everything to Heroku. I'm going to add everything here. I'm going to say added C2B payments model. I'm going to push this to Heroku. I'm going to close this, and as well as the admin. I leave the C2B open, and I'm going to close the models. But we've not done anything here to save. So the way we save it is that because the information is coming, so we can even fail to do the, in the confirmation API view, we can fail to do the dev create. So in this case, for example, if I come and hide everything like that. So there are two ways you can do about it. You can hide everything because you are going to get this data as it is. So I can hide everything like that. Let's see what will happen. And I can come and save that. I'm going to say plain. I'm going to push this to Heroku. Push to Heroku. And we are going to see if it's going to save, because ideally we should receive this data. And once we receive this data, it's supposed to use this serializer and save it. Let's see if it's going to save. If it's not going to, we are going to activate this function again, and we can do some few things to save the data. So as it's pushing, I'm going to come here and make sure that the build has been started. It's okay. Now waiting for it to complete. Okay, it seems it has completed. So I'm going to come here to C2B. I'm going to run this transaction. Run invalid syntax. Let's see where the problem is. I'm saying business shortcode. Where have we written that? Let me come to the views. It's okay. Was it probably in the models? No, here everything seems okay. The only other place we've done that is in the admin. This is okay. It's saying the error here is, let me see. Business shortcode shuffle max length is equals to 6. So that was in our models. Let me see. Okay, let me look at the logs. And here on the logs, I'm finding that, oh, we need to insert this. So we need to run migrations in Heroku. So I'm going to come and say Heroku run python manage.py migrate. Saying it has applied the migrations. Okay, so let me refresh this. Works. C2B payments, here we should receive something. Once we run now again, okay, I'm going to come back here. I'm going to close this. Control Shift P. Wait for it to pop up. Control Shift P. I'm going to run Python file in terminal. Let's see. Okay, access token okay, because it's running the from here, get access token and accept successfully. If I now come to our server, should not be able to receive any message here. We're seeing it has just called our confirmation URL, but if we come to our code, just a second, if we come here to our code, it's because in our views we've disabled this create method. But since we've done a transaction of, let me close this, since we've done a transaction of 3 shillings at my account number, when we open up now the C2B and refresh, we should be able to see the transaction. Just to confirm is the correct one. If I click on here, is this, and B reference number is my account number, which is which is here. So that's pretty much the basic way in which you can save. Of course, in the next video, what we are going to do is that we are going to come and do a create method ourselves, because we need to format a few things. One of the things we need to do is because we've received this as a trans time, we can format this to from a string to an actual date time, which is not a naive date time, but time zone aware. We'll also convert the trans amount into a float field instead of a string. Another thing we can do is let me see, also organization account balance, and convert this to a float number. And also we'll do some few validations. Again, let me just do maybe one final transaction. I'm going to come here and send 5 or 4 so that it's incremental. I say my account number 1. Control Shift P. I run Python file in terminal. Success. And now if I come here and go back, C2B payments, should be able to see the second one, which is here. And if I click on it, I should be able to receive everything. Again, guys, as always, if you're finding me for the first time, please make sure to follow me on my various social media platforms, as well as subscribe to the channel. I look forward to seeing you in the next one. If you have any questions, please drop a comment in the section box below, and I'll get back to you. See you in the next one.